Welcome to Biology at Ease. In my previous video, I gave a brief introduction about the fundamental units of life, that is the cell. Now, in this video, I'll be explaining the three major parts of the cell, the plasma membrane, nucleus, and cytoplasm. So let's begin with the first part, plasma membrane. Plasma membrane, also known as cell membrane, is a delicate layer which covers the cell. It is present in both prokaryotic as well as eukaryotic cells. It is an elastic membrane and selectively permeable in nature. That means it allows the entry of only certain substances inside the cell. It is a living membrane and has high regenerative capacity. Talking about the composition, plasma membrane consists of a bilayer of lipids and proteins along with carbohydrate molecules that are present at the surface of the bilayer. The lipid molecules are arranged in such a way that the hydrophilic head of the lipid molecules are present at the outer surface of the plasma membrane, whereas the hydrophobic tail is present towards the inner side of the plasma membrane. So let's draw the structure of the plasma membrane. This is the hydrophilic head of the lipid molecules facing the outer surface of the plasma membrane, while the hydrophobic end is towards the inner side of the plasma membrane. Now, the protein molecules are present on the surface of the lipid molecules. And at some places, above the protein molecules are present carbohydrate molecules. These are the carbohydrate molecules, protein molecules attached with the lipid molecules, and these are the lipid molecules with hydrophobic and hydrophilic ends. Now, the lipid molecules present in the plasma membrane are majorly of two types. First is cholesterol and second is phospholipids. Protein molecules are also of two types, intrinsic protein molecules and extrinsic protein molecules. The intrinsic protein molecules are completely or partially embedded within the lipid molecules, while the extrinsic protein molecules are present at the surface of the lipid molecules. The carbohydrates present within the plasma membrane includes sialic acid, hexoses, hexamine, and fucose. In human cell, proteins account for about 50% of the plasma membrane, while lipid constitutes 40% of the plasma membrane, and the remaining 10% is occupied by carbohydrates. The passage of molecules across the plasma membrane takes place either with the expenditure of energy called as active transport or without the use of energy called passive transport. Now coming to the functions of the plasma membrane, since plasma membrane is the covering of the cell, therefore it is protective in nature. It determines the shape of the cell. It is responsible for determining the solutes which will enter or exit across the plasma membrane. Now, as I have told in my previous video that in some organisms like in plants, fungi and some protists, there is one more layer that covers the plasma membrane and this layer is called cell wall. Unlike plasma membrane which is living in nature, cell wall is rigid and dead, that is it lacks regenerative capacity. Cell wall is freely permeable in nature, that is it allows the entry of all the substances inside the cell. The composition of cell wall varies from organism to organisms. For example, in fungi the cell wall is made up of chitin. In plants, the cell wall is made up of cellulose, whereas the plasma membrane has a definite composition consisting of proteins, lipids and carbohydrates. So let's summarize everything. Plasma membrane, the outer covering of the cell, highly flexible in nature, consisting of protein, lipids and carbohydrates. It is a selectively permeable membrane and in some organisms, it is covered by another layer called cell wall. So that's it about plasma membrane. Now let's move on to nucleus. Nucleus is an oval or spherical structure present inside the cell. It was discovered by a botanist called Robert Brown. It is known as the director of the cell since it is responsible for controlling all the cellular activities. It is the largest cellular structure known. Talking about the composition, nucleus consists of 80% of proteins, 12% DNA, 5% RNA and 3% lipids. It has four major components: nuclear membrane, nucleolus, nucleoplasm, and chromatin material. Nuclear membrane, also known as nuclear envelope, consists of two layers: outer nuclear membrane and inner nuclear membrane. This membrane is discontinuous in nature, consisting of pores known as nuclear pores, which are responsible for exchange of materials across the nuclear membrane. At second, we have nucleolus, which is a non-membrane bound structure. It consists of RNA and proteins and is the site for ribosome synthesis, and ribosome helps in protein synthesis in the cytoplasm. Thirdly, we have nucleoplasm. Nucleoplasm is the sap present inside the nucleus, consisting of various substances like nucleotides and certain enzymes. The last component is chromatin material. Chromatin material is a network of thread-like structures present inside the nucleus, and during cell division, this chromatin material becomes thick and condensed and form chromosomes. These chromosomes consist of DNA and proteins. Talking about the functions of nucleus, nucleus is responsible for controlling all the cellular activities, therefore it is known as the director of the cell. Nucleus is responsible for ribosome synthesis. Nucleus contains the genetic information and is responsible for transfer of hereditary material from one generation to another. So that's all about nucleus. Now let's move on to the last part, that is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the protoplasmic content of the cell within the plasma membrane, excluding the nucleus. So this region of the cell is known as cytoplasm. It consists of two major parts. The first one is cytosol, and the second is cell organelles. The fluid part of cytoplasm is known as cytosol, and it consists of various enzymes, ions, amino acids, lipids, and proteins. Cell organelles refers to the submicroscopic structures present in the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the site for synthesis of various biochemical processes like glycolysis. It is responsible for exchange of material between different cell organelles, and it helps in protein synthesis. So that's all for this video. I hope you like the content. Please subscribe to my channel for the upcoming videos. Thank you so much for watching.